Good morning, children. I'm Mrs. Monica Biswas. We'll be teaching you maths today. Okay, so today we'll start with a new chapter, that is chapter number 5, tens and ones. So before starting with this chapter, let us understand or let us learn what exactly tens mean. Alright, so I have given you some, made some example on the board. Okay, here there are 10 sticks. Can you see? 10 sticks, let us count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so these are 10 sticks and we can also call them 10 ones. Alright, now if I bring all these sticks together, if I tie them together with one thread or with one rope, what it will become? It will become one bundle. That means it is 110. Alright, so both the sticks have the same number. There is no increase in number. Alright, 10 sticks, that means one bundle. Alright, so that is why 10 ones is equal to 110. Alright children, now this number, this two digit number, which you can see it have two number, that is 0 and 1. Alright, this is first and the smallest two digit number, children. Alright, this is for your, just for your information, that this is the first and the smallest two digit number. Now let us learn how to put these two numbers in ones and tens column. Alright, so I am making one column over here which has ones and tens. Okay, now can you see this number 0? This is on which side? This is on the right side. So that I will put in ones place. Alright children, now see the next number, that is number 1, which is on the left hand side, that will go in the tens column. Alright, so this is how we will write the number in ones and tens place. Alright, is it clear? Alright, now let's move on to the next thing, that how to break the number and learn its name. Now suppose if I write 110 plus 11, that will give me 11. Alright, see 110 plus 11, that is 11. Alright, now see the next one. 110 plus 2 ones, that will give me 12. 110 plus 3 ones, that will give me 13. 110 plus 4 ones, that will give me 14. Alright, like this, we will go further also. One ten plus 5 ones, that will give me 50. 110 plus 6 ones, that will give me 16. 110 plus 7 ones, that will give me 17. 110 plus 8 ones, that will give me 18. 110 plus 9 ones, that will give me 19. Plus 110 plus 10 ones, that will give me 20. This is how we will read the number over here. Alright, now let's make a group of 10. Alright, how, same like this bundle, how we have made the group. Similarly, we will make the group of 10. Now, suppose make a group of 10. Alright, suppose I have 12 flowers. Alright, how many flowers I have? 12 flowers. Just I am making the 12 flowers. You start counting them. Okay, I am making all the flowers on the board. start counting, okay? One by one, start counting that I have made 12 or not. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay? So, I have made 12 flowers over here. Now, I have to make a group of 10 over here. So, start counting. Alright? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop over here and make a big circle around it. Okay? This is a group of 10 over here. Alright, one more example I gave you. Suppose I have 13 balls. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Alright, so this is 13 ball. Start counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Alright, so there are 13 balls over here. So we make a group of 10 over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Stop over here and make a circle. Make a group of 10. Alright. So is it clear to you children? Now we have learned how to make a group of 10. Now next thing we will learn how to write the numbers also. When we are making a group, we will learn how to write the number in ones and tens place also. Alright, now suppose see this first flower. I have made a group of 10 over here. So first I will count how many total number of flowers are over here. So there are 12 flowers over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I will write over here 12. Total number of flowers are 12. So now I will write this number in ones and tens column. Alright children? In ones and tens column. So this is my ones column and this is my tens column. See the first number which is on the right hand side, that will go on the ones place. The number which is on the left hand side, that will go on the tens place. Alright, now similarly, we'll solve the ball one also. So I have how many balls? 13 balls over here. Alright, so I will write the total number of ball 13 over here. Okay, then I will write in ones and tens column. Okay children, this is my ones column and this is my tens column, okay? Again, the number which is on the right hand side, that will go on the ones column. The number which is on the left hand side, that is one, that will go on the tens column. Alright, so have you understood this? How to make a group and how to write the number in ones and tens place. Alright children, now let's move on to the next topic, that is, we'll practice some more. So children, as we have learned how to write ones and tens in the ones and tens number in the place, okay, so we'll solve some more exercise, okay, related to ones and tens. So let us see how to write the numbers in ones and tens place. Alright, now so see, look here. The question is write these number in tens and ones place. Alright, now so let's see the first number, that is number 74. So how you will write that 74 in tens and ones place? Children, keep one thing in mind, that always the number which is on the right hand side, you have to take that number first. Alright, the first number that is on the right hand side, that is 4, that will go on the ones place. So I have written 4 over here. Now which number is left? The number 7 is left, that will go in the tens place. Similarly, now see the next number, that is 35. Alright, so same, the number which is on the right hand side, that is number 5, which will go on the ones place, and 3 in the tens column. Alright, now see the third one, 39. Again, the right hand side number, that is 9, that will go in ones place. Alright, and the number which is on the left hand side, 3, that will go in tens column. Alright, now see the fourth one, 76. Alright, so number 6 will go on ones place. And number 7, which is on the left hand side, that will go in the tens place. Alright, now see the next number, that is 4040. Alright, so 0 will go in the ones place because 0 means nothing. Okay, so it will be going on ones place. Now 4, that will go in the tens place. Alright, now see number 6. The number is 88. Alright, so the number which is on the right hand side, that will go in the ones column. That is number 8. And the number which is on the left hand side, that is number 8. That will go in the tens column. Okay, so don't get confused. Always see that which number, the number which is on the right hand side, that will go on the ones place. Okay, and the number which is on the left hand side, that will go on the tens column. Alright, now let's see number 81. Alright, now one is on which side? That is on the right hand side. So I will bring that number over here in the ones column. Alright, now see the number 8, which is on the left hand side, that will go in the tens column. Okay, now see the last one, 97. Alright, say this number 7 will go here in the ones column. Alright, and the number which is left, that is 9, that will go in the tens column. Alright, I hope you have understood this exercise, how to write the number in ones and tens place. So children, practice some more sums at home. Tell your parents to give some more sums on ones and tens so that you can be perfect in doing ones and tens, putting the ones and tens in correct places. Alright, now let's move on to the next topic, that is missing numbers. Alright, so children, you have learned numbers from KG section. Alright, from KG classes you are learning the numbers. Okay, so today we will learn the numbers, we will write the numbers in a very interesting way. Okay, now how? Everyone know how to travel? Everyone loves traveling? Yes? Okay, so some like to travel in bus, train, aeroplane and so on. So today we'll travel in a train. Alright children? So let's see how. So I have made a train with one engine over here. Alright, so there are so many trains I have made. Now in some train the engine has the number, and even some bogies which is at the back, okay, they also have some numbers, but some bogie does not have any numbers. So okay, so we'll give them some numbers. Alright, so let's begin with the missing numbers. Okay, so today's topic is missing number. Alright, so let's fill this number in this train boxes. Alright, so first number, that is 10, that the engine has number 10. Okay, now let's move on to the next bogie. After engine, the first bogie is there. This does not have any number over here. Okay, so what number comes after 10? Okay, what number comes after 10? 11, correct. So I will write over here 11. Is it clear? Okay, so my next bogie is also having the number, that is 12. Now after 12, there are two bogies which does not have any numbers. Alright, so I have to give numbers over here. Alright, so see number 12. After 12, which number will come? 13. And after 13, which number? 14. Okay, now after 14, next bogie is already having number 15 over here. Can you see? Yes. Okay, now after 15, see there are two bogies. No, there are more bogies. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 bogies, it does not have any numbers over here. Alright, so let's start the number, writing the numbers after 15. After 15, what number will come? 16, 17, 18, 19, and the last number is 20. Alright, so my one train bogie numbers are over. Now let's move on to the next train. This is a small train, okay, which has only three bogies over here. Okay, so the first bogie number is 16. Alright, so next bogie, it does not have any number. So what number will come after 16? That is 17. Okay, after 17, 18 is written over here. Correct? Okay, so now let's move on to the third train. Okay, see the first bogie, it has number 13 over here. Alright, so after that, what number will come? 14. 15 already is there, the bogie number is there, 15. Okay, so we have written all the bogie numbers over here. On the basis of all these numbers, we will do the next question. Okay, we have all the bogies, we have the numbers also. Okay, so we will use all these numbers in solving the next question, children. Alright, now look at the fourth question. Now, what number comes after 18? Okay, just look at the bogies over here. Where is 18? 18 number bogie here. Okay, so after 18, what number will come? 19. And the next number? 20. So I will write over here 19, 20. Okay, so next number, question is 5. What comes before 16? Okay, so look at the bogie number 16 over here. Can you see 16? Here? Yes. So what number is before 16? 50. So I will write over here 50. Now let's move on to the next question, number 6. Write the numbers before and after 18. Okay, now let's see the bogie number 18. Okay, now what number is before 18? That is 17. Alright, what number is after 18? That is 19. So I will write over here 17, 19. 18 is already written over here. So we just have to fill the number which is before 18 and after 18. Alright, now let's move on to the next question. That's the seventh one. What comes after 14? Okay, so after 14, look at the bogie number. After 14, which number is there? 15. And the next number, 16. So I will write over here 15 and 16. Okay, so last question, number 8. Write the numbers before and after 9. Alright, so look at the bogie number 9. There is no bogie number 9. So what should we do? We all have learned numbers, no? So start counting from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So what number came before 9? 8. So I will write over here 8. 9 is over here. So after 9 is 10. Okay, children? So, is this clear to you? Okay, so practice this sum in your notebook. Okay, so that you will be thorough with all these missing numbers. Alright, although you have already done it before, but still we are doing this number to you. Okay.